So, Banners, Mike Banners is here. He's over there to help the video lads. He sat behind them.
I've not seen him do much help, to be honest with you.
I know, but I'm just saying that just in case. And he's, I mean, we're all outside.
I thought he was going to play us out like it was an American talk show.
Well, I haven't broached him the idea that I want to basically do Don't Forget Your Toothbrush somehow, and he's very involved. He doesn't know that yet. I'm going to at some point raise that with him, but now might not be the time. But he's, he says to me, sort of beforehand, and he's absolutely right, like, we are so much. It's fair to say that Liverpool people and Liverpool supporters are very good at believing their own bullshit. And we're going to be phenomenal at believing our own bullshit off the back of what no supporters in the ground has meant. Like, say what you want. This season, those pricks who represent Liverpool Football Club have really made it clear that this means more and that football without fans is nothing.
Yeah, I'm going to go into a strict negotiation on my season ticket price in the summer. And I'll be honest, I'm going to start at a minus. Yeah. Like, what are you paying me to come next year? Because you've been fucking crap without me, to be honest with you. And I'm not saying all me, do you know what I mean? But I think we should all, maybe collective bargaining, we can all get together, get Jay McKenna to lead the union and say, get him out of retirement with his megaphone and say how much we're willing to accept they pay us to come back.
Yeah, pay
and
match.
I wanted to at least cover me ale. Well, and I fucking drink, Neil.
I want them what I want. Like, we could agree with them. Listen, it's a pleasure to watch us play Man City and Man United, so we'll pay for that one.
Okay.
But you've got to weigh us in for Brighton. You really. And then you can bring us to a performance review if
you
want.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? We'll all have KPIs together.
Yeah.
And have that agreement with them.
Yeah.
Because that's in my head. Because, I mean, let's be honest about this. There is the remarkably bleak concept before this match, and I know that people watching this probably don't want more bleak concepts. I think that we're beautifully primed to be the first team in football history to go out on away goals, having played both games against both opponents in the same neutral venue.
Yeah.
Like, it's beautifully set up for me, this.
Yeah, no, I've had my eye on it for a while. Fans of my Twitter will know that I first had my eye on the fact that, you know, it could happen with both games at neutral venues, and then when it was potentially the same one, I was like, oh, this is too beautiful, isn't it? It's too gorgeous not to happen to someone. And why not us, this of all years?
That's what I'm left with. And then the next phase of this is the whole purpose. Like, I'm banging. A lot of people don't like the away goals rule anymore. Gobshites like Phil Blundell have decided it's anachronistic, and it's one of the many things that Phil's wrong about is this.
That and vegetables.
That and vegetables all day. And you're left, you know, in this. I'll stick up for the away goals rule. I really will. I think it changes the dynamic. I thought it was great, even though it punishes us in the Atletico game last year, where in the first leg, I went from being absolutely desperate that we equalise to thinking to myself, no, we can't concede another, to then thinking to myself, right now it's really important we get one last five. And I went through that journey, and it's solely because of the away goals rule. So I love the away goals rule, but it is utterly ridiculous if no one's in the ground. And part of why it's great to finish top of your Champions League group is that you get to have the second leg at home. And we've got the second leg at home, but in Budapest and with no fans.
It is mad. I also hate the idea that, like, oh, we can't change it now the competition started. It's like, you're changing the handball rule every fortnight at the moment. We're getting another memo through from somewhere. Like, oh, this is it now. If your hands are like this, it's Sam, but don't do them like that.
Yeah.
Whatever you do. And so we're getting that every fortnight at the moment. And obviously things are mad. And I don't know. It feels like they can if they want to.
I felt like I got the handball rule, and there was the Kante one, and we were crap against Chelsea and we didn't deserve anything. But I feel like Kante got away with the Kante one, because his hands were like this for ages, so he didn't move them. But I'm still like, but your hands shouldn't be like this.
Yeah.
And they just shouldn't be. It's really bad.
Yeah.
Like, put your hands down, move them away.
Mm.
But yeah, that handball, no, they could have changed it. They haven't changed it. They could have changed lots of things. You know, like, for instance, I think they should have found a way to just do all of these as one-off games in neutral venues, to be frank.
Yeah.
And there was a way to do that, make the money still work for everybody broadly the same. You know, there's a lot. I've really enjoyed footballs. We can't change things until we change them quite dramatically this season.
Yeah, it is mad. Maybe it's because they can't all have a big lunch, and that's what they're all really in it for.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, you want me to change stuff without the big lunch?
Yeah.
Absolutely not. So maybe there's a little bit of that going on. They're hanging on until the big lunch, and then they're just going to change all sorts, but it's going to be too late.
You could be right.
Too late for the Reds.
Too late for the Reds. I mean, I've decided that'd be the bleakest way to exit, would be to go out on the away goals rule.
Yeah. It certainly would. But I was thinking on the way over here, and this is just going to add to the bleakness, I don't really buy the Liverpool can't win scenario because you always can. So you know what I mean? So, oh, this is a no-win situation.
Oh, no, this is a win team.
But I think for us tonight, you know, we are in a bit of a bad situation in that if we beat them, everyone's like, well, they beat them a couple of weeks ago. Do you know what I mean? Whereas if we lose and go through, everyone will still be really annoyed. Whereas normally if you lose and go through in Europe, you know, we've done it before and it's fine. Do you know what I mean? Roma, yeah. 2001, we lost and went through. It was brilliant. Whereas I think if we lose and go through, people have got to comment off. Obviously, if we lose and go out with our away goal scenario, there'll be people jumping in the river over there and stuff like that. So it's a tough one tonight. I think unless we absolutely batter them, I don't think it's going to make anyone feel better, and it could get a lot worse. So there's more gloom.